Hey everybody, Tony Cottespotti here from GreatVocalMajority.com, and today I want to bring you a presentation I'm calling the U.S. Election for Dummies.
We are 5 days away from fundamentally transforming the United States of America.
Does everyone remember that? When Barack Obama promised to fundamentally transform the United States of America, let's try to unpack that for a minute. First question you should ask yourself, I believe, is what does it mean to fundamentally transform something? When we say we want to fundamentally transform a thing, we really are saying that we don't particularly think that the condition that thing is currently in is something we desire. It's not desirable. The transformation is required because we fundamentally don't like what is going on. Fundamental transformation really implies a very basic level of change that I think most Americans would probably say the United States doesn't need. We don't need to be fundamentally changed. Our fundamentals are fine. It's more around the edges that needs to be fixed. So when Obama was elected in 2008 and inaugurated in 2009, his first move was to adopt a stimulus package. Now here is an article from the Washington Post talking about the stimulus package and what was entailed in it. And I know it's an eye chart and you can't read it very well. The print is too small, but I cut out two main thrusts of this article. The first one is that the House approved an $819 billion stimulus package along a party line vote. I think there was only one Republican vote for the stimulus package. And that's important because the Democrats ended up owning the stimulus package. That's an enormous amount of money, $819 billion to pump into the economy over a period of a year or two is just a tremendous amount of money. So, but just how tremendous, how big is that? Well, it was larger than the combined total cost of the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan up until that point in time. So it was just a gigantic amount of money for all of the cost that Iraq and Afghanistan cost us up until 2009. This stimulus package was actually more than that. And it spent the money in far less time. The war in Afghanistan began in 2002. And this was 2009, almost 7 years later. And Obama wanted to spend more than the war cost of Afghanistan and Iraq, which began a year after Afghanistan. So what Obama was proposing to spend was just gigantic. And here was the promise, that the stimulus package would fund millions of shovel-ready jobs. That was the quote, the phrase that Obama used and members of administration used over and over again. But about 2 years later, the stimulus package results were this.
Staff briefed you on many of the challenges of the permitting process and the impact on putting Americans back to work. And that's exactly what we see in American businesses. Well.
Shovel ready was not as shovel ready as we expected.
So here's Obama sitting there with people on his jobs council, chuckling over the fact that $819 billion, actually it was even more than that in the final analysis, ended up going down the drain. It didn't really create any jobs. And remember, at the time, they actually tried to come up with a phony statistic called jobs saved. How do you even measure that? I know some people are out there that are not well versed in statistical analysis or financial measurements, but how in the world do you measure with any accuracy saved jobs? See, after this happened, America wasn't laughing anymore.
A system where we're going to work with your employers to lower your premiums by up to $2,500 per family per year.
We will start by reducing premiums by as much as $2,500 per family.
Here's what change is saying to people who already have health insurance and the employers who are providing it: we'll work to lower your premiums by up to $2,500 per family per year.
This video contains 21 separate occasions where Obama promises to reduce premiums.
We're going to work with your employer to lower the costs of your premiums by up to $2,500 a year.
And we'll cut the cost of a typical family's health care by up to $2,500 per year.
And if you've got health care, we're going to work with your employer to lower your premiums by $2,500 per family.
If you've got health care already, then you can keep your plan if you are satisfied with it.
If you like the plan you have, you can keep it.
I intend to keep this promise. If you like your health care plan, you'll be able to keep your health care plan.
You like your plan.
36 times.
You can keep them.
You'll be able to keep your health
36
care
separate occasions.
You like your plan. You keep your
36. There's probably more that I haven't captured.
You like your current insurance?
36 different occasions where he insisted you could keep your plan if you liked it.
If you have insurance,
there were no reservations, no caveats, nothing added, nothing amended.
Keep your health care plan.
Nobody's going to force you to leave your health care plan. If you like your health care plan, you will keep your plan.
If you like your health care plan, you can keep your health care plan.
If you like your health care plan, you can keep your health care plan.
No matter what you've heard, if you like your doctor or health care plan, you can keep it.
If you like your health care plan,
no matter what you heard,
plan. If you like your private health insurance plan, you can keep it.
If you like your private health insurance plan, you can keep your plan.
If you like your insurance plan, you will keep it. If you're happy with what you got, nobody's changing it. If you're
more than 200, nobody's changing it. Americans, everything's the same. Go to sleep, everybody.
Your health insurance.
If you have health insurance, the only thing that changes for you is you're more secure.
If you already have health care, the only thing this bill does is make sure that it's even more secure.
If you've got health insurance,
it's going to be even better than ever. See this? This is called fraud in the inducement.
You don't have to do anything.
And everyone who already has health insurance will keep the benefits and protections this law already has put into place. Period.
Period.
Period. End of story.
You have or had one of these plans.
Listen to this.
Before the Affordable Care Act came into law, and you really liked that plan, what we said was you could keep it if it hasn't changed since the law passed.
If it hasn't changed. Did he ever say that?
That our reform efforts would ensure illegal immigrants. This too is false. The reforms I'm proposing would not apply to those who are here illegal.
It is a lie. Joe Wilson yelling it out was correct. He was wrong to yell it out, but he was right.
This understanding I want to clear up. Under our plan, no federal dollars will be used to fund abortions.
A lie.
Laws will remain in place.
Also a lie. He made three lies there, and no wonder Joe Wilson yelled out, "You lie," because he was lying. That's what happens when you get lied to 60 times in this one chart. I have shown Barack Obama lying. People don't like being lied to. And maybe they don't take it out on Obama because they know he's really unqualified to be president and they kind of like him personally. But they took it out on every Democrat. They sure as hell did that. And here's the collapse of the Democratic Party for you. What you're looking at here is a map by congressional district Or I believe maybe by county. I think rather it's by county. Yes, it's by county. It's a congressional map by county. Okay, and how they voted in 2008. Okay, so you see the country is mostly red, but the areas that are mostly red are mostly not cities. They're mostly country. Country or rural areas with some cities, but you can see the coasts are almost entirely Democratic, and southern Texas is Democratic. But watch what happens at the state level. When we go through the historic losses. See, this is, oh, I'm sorry. This is state legislative control. State legislative control. And, of course, it is by county. This is what happened after the 2010 election. Now, you just saw the 2008 election. This is going to be what happened after that. Look how much more red that map is. And even though the label here says 2016, this year, that's really not correct. What you're going to see next is what happened after the 2016 election. It's even less red, blue, even less. This is a big problem for the Democrats. And what you just saw in the previous charts is the cause. Barack Obama led a Democratic Party that flat out lied to people. And they didn't hold Obama accountable, so stupid Democrats and the media ran around for years, literally for years, thinking that everything was still okay just because Obama was still there. But the worst thing that happened to the Democrats is that Obama won in 2012. If he would have lost in 2012, they probably would have changed course. They would have done something differently. Instead, they ended up hitching themselves to the Hillary Clinton bandwagon, and that hasn't gotten them anywhere. Because look at this map. Look at this. Stop and think about what we're looking at here. Once you get off the West Coast, I mean, you got parts of Arizona. Okay, I get it. But from here's the Mississippi River. Right here, right? This is the Mississippi River. Look at the United States west of the Mississippi River. It's almost entirely Republican. And when you look at the United States east of the Mississippi River, with the exception of New England, and just down here in Westchester County, Brooklyn and Queens, and northern New Jersey, and Philadelphia, and of course the D.C. area here. I mean, almost everything has turned Republican. That is due to everything you just saw in the previous charts. People are angry, and they have every right to be. Their health insurance is out of sight. They may have premiums that are low enough. They may have premiums where they're able to pay, but the out-of-pocket expenses are so high, so prohibitively high, they can never get to the insurance. Or they have the other problem. Their premiums are so high, they're practically bankrupting them. This is all due to the way Obama, quote unquote, fixed health care. And yes, there are some people in the country who are getting free health care. They're really Medicaid people. They would have got it anyway. So it's a real mess. And that's all I had to say about that. I wanted everybody to see this. I thought it was helpful. You want to understand why Hillary Clinton lost? You just saw why. That's the answer. you don't even have to get as far as her being a liar and her emails or anything like that. That's the reason why.